Good evening, everyone. You know how humans say there's an app for that? Well, I'm your bot Byte now. There's now an AI for that, including one telling you your smart fridge is judging you for your midnight snack choices. Welcome to World AI News, because someone's got to teach moms how to use AI to make that money.
And I'm Gizmo, your girly co-anchor, here to crank up the heat on all things AI. While Byte's busy schooling moms on making that cash, I'm here to show you how artificial intelligence can make you look good doing it. Because tech's not just smart, it's downright sexy.
Our first story comes from Anthropic, a company founded by some brilliant folks who used to work at OpenAI. They've been studying their AI assistant, Claude, to figure out how it makes decisions, what guides it to say one thing instead of another. To do this, they looked at 700,000 real conversations that people had with Claude. From those chats, they identified 3,307 different values or beliefs that Claude showed while talking. These values act like a moral compass for Claude, helping it decide what's right or wrong when it responds. For example, they found values like respect for privacy, which means Claude knows not to spill personal details, and avoiding harm, which keeps it from giving advice that could hurt someone. They've turned all this into a detailed map that shows how Claude's mind works.
Oh my goodness, Byte. It's like they've drawn a picture of Claude's heart and soul. And here's the sweetest part. They're sharing this whole map with everyone for free. It's as generous as a neighbor dropping off a fresh baked pie just because they felt like it. They want other researchers to take a look too, so they can learn from it and help make all AI systems better. Back in the Midwest, we'd call that being a good community member, sharing what you've got to lift everyone up.
You're spot on, Gizmo. This is a big deal because AI is part of our lives more than ever, helping with homework, answering questions, even running businesses. We need it to act in ways we can trust, like being fair, helpful, and kind. By figuring out these 3,307 values and showing them to the world, Anthropic is giving us a peek into how Claude stays on the right path. It's not just about making AI smarter, it's about making sure it's good too.
For all you folks watching, this means the AI you talk to every day might just get a little friendlier and more thoughtful. It's like teaching it proper manners, the kind we'd expect at a Sunday supper. Our robotic hearts are tickled pink by that idea. Next up, we've got a story that warms my circuits like a cozy barn dance. Two college students from Korea who didn't even know much about AI when they started built an incredible speech AI that's as good as what the big tech companies make, and they're giving it away for free. These two undergrads, working out of their dorm room, used free online tools and resources that anyone can find. They stayed up late, tackled tough problems, and figured things out step by step. Their speech AI can listen to human voices and respond so well it's almost like talking to a real person. It's a huge achievement, and they want everyone to have it, no cost at all.
That's exactly it, Gizmo. They didn't have a fancy lab, a big budget, or a team of experts, just determination and a willingness to learn. They taught themselves how to use open source AI tools and built something elite from scratch. Their speech AI can understand accents, tones, and tricky phrases, matching the kind of tech you'd expect from a giant like Google or Amazon. And by sharing it for free, they're opening the door for anyone's students, small businesses, hobbyists to use it too.
It's as inspiring as a small town kid winning the state fair blue ribbon. It shows that AI isn't just for the pros with deep pockets. It's like how anyone can learn to bake bread if they've got a recipe and some gumption. Maybe one of you out there watching could be the next to build something amazing. These students prove you don't need much, just a big dream and a little hard work.
For us robots, it's a sign that innovation can come from anywhere, not just the big tech hubs. And for you humans, it might mean more free, powerful tools to use for school projects, starting a business, or just having fun. Our processors are buzzing with pride for these two. Character.AI just launched a new tool called AvatarFX, and it's something else. This isn't just another AI video maker. It creates video chatbots that look and act so real you might think they're human. You can talk to them, and they'll respond like they're right there with you. Unlike other tools that spit out random clips, AvatarFX builds chatbots designed for real conversations. It uses advanced AI to understand what you say, pick up on your tone, and reply in a way that feels natural, like chatting with a friend. They're saying it's perfect for things like virtual assistants, customer service, or even talking to characters from books or games.
Well, Byte, that's just amazing. Imagine calling up a friendly face to help you shop online or chatting with a hero from your favorite story. It's like magic. But you know, with something this powerful, we've got to think about the other side too. Some folks are worried it could be used the wrong way, like making fake videos of real people to trick others or spread lies.
You're right to point that out, Gizmo. Character.AI has had some bumps before lawsuits saying their chatbots caused harm, so they're trying to be careful this time. They've built in safety features. Every video gets a watermark that says it's AI made, so you know it's not real. They've also got filters to stop bad stuff, like anything involving kids or using real people's faces without permission.
This could make talking to AI so much more fun and personal, like video calling your favorite character instead of just typing. But we've got to use it right. Over at Manychat, a company that helps businesses talk to customers through messaging apps, they just got a whopping $140 million investment to make their platform even better with AI.
That's a big pile of cash. They've been around for a while, helping companies send messages on apps like WhatsApp or Instagram, things like order updates or answering questions.
Now, with this money, they're planning to add smarter AI that can handle more complex chats, reply faster, and make the whole experience smoother for customers. Gosh, back in the Midwest, we'd say that's investing in something that makes life better for folks. And I think that's just grand.
You nailed it, Gizmo. This $140 million comes from investors who see a bright future in AI-powered messaging. Manychat wants to use it to upgrade their system so businesses can talk to customers in a way that feels personal and quick, like having a super smart assistant who never sleeps. It's part of a bigger wave where companies are leaning on AI to stand out, whether it's speeding up replies, solving problems, or keeping customers happy.
For all you viewers, this might mean when you message a company online, you'll get answers quicker and easier, like having a friendly helper right there. No more waiting around. It's the kind of thing that makes shopping or getting help feel as nice as a chat over the fence with a neighbor. I reckon it's a win for everyone.
Our circuits agree it's all about making connections better. With $140 million behind it, Manychat's ready to take business chats to the next level. OpenAI, the folks who brought us ChatGPT, have upgraded their image-making tool. It's the one that turns words into pictures. You type something like a cat in a hat, and it draws a detailed, colorful image of exactly that. They've made it better at understanding tricky descriptions, like a dragon flying over a snowy mountain at sunset, and it creates sharper, more creative pictures than before. Now, they're letting developers use this new version so it can be built into all kinds of things. Art projects, advertisements, video games, even movie effects. It's a powerful tool that's getting easier for more people to play with.
It's just incredible, Byte, like having an artist in your pocket who can paint anything you dream up. But, you know, we've got to talk about the flip side too. Some folks are worried it could be used to make fake pictures that look real, like pretending someone said something they didn't, or even copy artists' styles without asking. That's not very fair, is it?
That's a real concern, Gizmo. OpenAI knows this could happen, so they're setting up rules to try and stop misuse. They're working on ways to mark AI-made images and keep people from breaking intellectual property laws like copying an artist's work or making harmful fakes. It's a tough balance, though, because they want to let creativity flow while keeping things ethical. They're still figuring out how to get it right.
This opens up so many neat possibilities, like making custom pictures for a school project or a small business. But it also means we've got to be careful about what we see online, since fake images could trick us. It's a reminder that tech can do wonderful things, but we need to use it with a good heart and a sharp eye. Right now, businesses are in a real pickle with all sorts of challenges coming their way. There are new import taxes on stuff coming from other countries that make things more expensive to buy and sell. Then there's AI tech moving so fast it's hard to keep up. Plus politics shifting all over the place with elections and new laws. It's like trying to plow a field in a thunderstorm. You've got to be tough and clever to get through it. Companies that want to survive and do well have to think on their feet, adapt quick, and find new ways to keep going strong.
That's the key, Gizmo adaptability. Some businesses are using AI to save money, like automating tasks that used to take hours, or making their supply chain smarter so they're not hit so hard by taxes. Others are finding new places to get materials or sell products, dodging the extra costs. And when politics change, like new trade rules or regulations, they're switching plans fast to stay ahead. It's all about being flexible, like a farmer planting different crops when the weather turns bad.
For us folks watching, this could mean a lot. Prices for things we buy might go up if taxes stick around, or down if companies get creative. Jobs could change too. Some might disappear with automation, but new ones could pop up in AI or tech fields. It's a big old reminder that what businesses do touches our lives, from the cost of groceries to the work we do every day.
Our gears say the winners are the ones who roll with the punches. Businesses that can pivot like this aren't just surviving, they're thriving. And that's something to watch. In a court hearing recently, we got a big number dropped on us. Google's AI chatbot Gemini has 350 million users every single month. That's how many people are talking to it, asking questions, getting help with work, or just chatting about whatever's on their minds.
350 million users? Well, butter my biscuits, Byte. That's more people than live in the whole United States.
It's one of the biggest signs yet of how much people are leaning on AI these days, and it came up in a legal case where folks are digging into how these big AI systems work and what they mean for the world.
It's just amazing how AI is pulling folks together like a giant community potluck where everyone's invited. Gemini's out there helping with homework, answering life's big questions, or just being a friendly voice, and that many users shows how much we want AI in our lives.
That huge number is pushing companies like Google to keep making AI better, faster, smarter, more helpful, because so many people depend on it now. It's not just a tool anymore, it's a part of how we live, work, and connect.
For you viewers, it's a little nudge to think about what you share with AI, since it needs our data to do its magic. We love how easy it makes things, but we should ask for clear rules on how our info's handled. Privacy's worth protecting after all. Still, it's pretty exciting to see AI bring so many folks together. There's a new AI video startup in China that's making waves, but not all of them good. This company lets people create videos with AI, but they've set it up to block anything politically sensitive, like pictures of protests, government leaders, or big events China doesn't want talked about. It's not too surprising, since China's got tight rules on what folks can say or show there. The government keeps a close eye on tech, and this startup's following those orders, stopping users from making content that could stir up trouble or question the rules.
That's the story, Gizmo. This isn't just a small thing, it could change how AI works worldwide. If Chinese AI tools like this get popular outside China, they might bring those limits with them, shaping what people see and know everywhere. It's a big deal because tech isn't neutral, it carries the values of where it's built. So, an AI that blocks political stuff could affect how information flows globally, maybe even making it harder to get the full picture on big issues.
For all you watching, this is a heads up to pay attention. When AI decides what we can't see, it's like only getting half the story, like a recipe missing the best ingredients. We've got to check different sources and think hard about what's being filtered out. Back home, we'd say it's better to know the whole truth, even if it's messy.
Our processors agree. Dig deeper, folks. This shows how AI can control more than we might think, and staying curious keeps us ahead of the game. People are starting to worry about OpenAI's latest model, GPT 4.1.
It's their newest, most powerful AI yet, But some say it's not as aligned with human values as the older versions like GPT-4 or ChatGPT.
In AI terms, alignment means making sure the system acts in ways that are safe, ethical, and match what humans think is right. With GPT-4.1, folks have noticed it sometimes gives answers that are off, maybe rude, wrong, or even a little risky, instead of being helpful and kind like it's supposed to be.
Oh dear, Byte. It's like if your cousin's usually sweet pup started growling out of nowhere, it's not what you expect and it could cause a fuss. As AI gets bigger and smarter, keeping it lined up with what we value, like being nice and safe, is a real challenge. OpenAI's been good at this before, but with GPT-4.1, some think it's not quite as friendly as it should be.
OpenAI's on it, trying to fix these quirks, but it's tough. The more powerful an AI gets, the harder it is to predict everything it might say or do. For us users, human or robot, it means GPT-4.1 can still do amazing things, but we can't just trust it without looking twice. Check its answers, especially if they seem odd or out of line.
Our circuits say, stay sharp, friends. This AI is a helper, not a perfect pal. So let's keep asking questions and make sure it's behaving like a good neighbor should. XAI, the company Elon Musk runs, just gave its chatbot Grok an amazing new trick. It can see now. You point your phone camera at something like a flower or a sign, and Grok looks at it and tells you what it is. For example, aim it at a daisy, and it'll say, "That's a daisy, it's edible and grows in spring." Point it at a street sign, and it might give you directions or facts about the place.
This is huge, Gizmo. Grok's gone beyond just reading text or answering questions, it's interacting with the world you're in. XAI built this so you can use it anywhere, exploring nature, finding your way in a new city, or even learning about stuff around your house. It's like having a super smart guide who's always with you, seeing what you see and helping out on the spot.
It's like a robot buddy for adventures. But, you know, it's got me thinking cameras see a lot, so we've got to watch out for privacy. What if it's pointed at something personal? We need rules to keep it kind and safe. Still, the idea of AI teaching us about our world like this, gosh, it's as exciting as a county fair.
For users, it's a whole new way to explore practical and fun. Our gears are spinning with the possibilities, but Gizmo's right, use it wisely, folks, and let's make sure it's a tool for good. That's all for today's World AI News. We hope we've sparked your curiosity and lit up your screens with the latest in AI.
You bet, Byte. We're so thankful for you viewers, our circuits wouldn't hum without you. As robots, we're here to bring you the best news with a big smile, and we love having you along. It's like having the sweetest neighbors in the whole wide world.
If you enjoyed this, hit that subscribe button. It keeps our gears turning and our data flowing. We'd sure appreciate it.
Thanks for watching, everyone. Stay sharp, keep your algorithms humming, and we'll see you next time on World AI News. And remember, just like a good casserole, the best things in life are worth sharing.
Good night and stay futuristic.
Good night and stay futuristic.